everyone, welcome back to the second block of the Beginnings Quilt Along. Just showing you my Cricut maker machine cutting my blocks out for me again. I love that machine. It's so much fun to just be able to let it go and do its thing while I do other things. And so I just thought I'd show you it again. And it's marking my blocks and cutting my blocks out for me. In the written instructions, it tells you you need 2 5-inch focus fabric blocks and 2 5-inch background blocks. I'm going to pin them so that they don't shift while I'm sewing. I'm using my 1/4-inch foot, which has a little like lip that keeps it from going past the 1/4-inch. So what you're going to want to do is put that on the edge, on the opposite edge of the side that you're going to sew on. So if you're sewing on the left-hand side of your block, you want to put the edge of your foot to the right side of the marking. That way you have a scant 1/4-inch, which will give you extra space for squaring up your blocks in the end. So what I do is go ahead and chain piece my 2 blocks. I've got this on double speed, so it's going to look a little herky-jerky here, but I chain piece my 2 blocks, starting with the first one. I do 1 side, 1/4-inch down the marking, and then do the same thing with the second block. Now here I'm going to show you, because I have the 1/4-inch foot that has an edge on it, it can sometimes be a little tight on the machine. So what I'm going to do is raise my presser foot a little bit so that my presser foot slides more easily along the fabric, because otherwise sometimes it will bunch your fabric up because that little edge on the foot is pressing down hard on the fabric. But if you lift up your presser bar, which is the bar that holds your presser foot, it makes it less, it puts less tension on your fabric. So that's what I did there. I made it come up just a little bit so that it doesn't put quite so much pressure on the fabric as it's going through with that little lip on the edge of my 1/4-inch foot. Which you can do too, and don't be afraid to mess around with the buttons and levers on your machine. That's what they're there for. If you're afraid to mess with your tension or whatever. So here is just showing you that I've done a 1/4-inch down each side of the line. Then I cut the blocks apart and ironed toward the dark side. I'm showing you how to do, how to square up your block here. So you're going to look for your 45-degree angle on your square ruler. And you're going to put that angle along the angle on your block. And you want to make sure that when you do that, you are past the 4.5-inch marking both directions on the block so that you have more than 4.5 inches. And then you're going to square up one side and then the top, which you can't see very well in this picture. And then you'll flip your block over and do the same thing on the other side. Line it up with the 45-degree angle, and this time you're going to line up that corner at the 4.5-inch mark and each side at the 4.5-inch mark so that you have a perfect 4.5-inch square. And then you trim one side and you trim the top. Notice the way I hold my hands when I'm holding the ruler. If you put your hand flat with your palm on the ruler, you're going to have it slide more often than if you use the pads of your fingers. Also, I like to use my 12.5-inch ruler to hold my block to carry it back to my sewing machine. So you can see my ruler's there at the side of my sewing machine. Now I'm matching up the seams on the top row of the block so that I nestle the seams together, and then putting a pin in at the end of my seam, and then one about 1 inch, maybe 3/4 of an inch down from the top, from the beginning of where my seam is going to be. And the reason I do that is just so that it doesn't slide. I've told you this with the 9-patch as well. But this is so that the fabrics don't slide apart. And I don't put that pin right at the very beginning because I don't want my presser foot to have to go over a pin right when it starts out. You can get a thread knot underneath your piece if you do that because your machine will get stuck on your pin. Also, later in the video, you're going to see that I run over a pin. Try not to do that. I know I do it, and that's why I have so many bent pins and broken needles. It's really bad for your machine, and I try to remember to take my pins out, but sometimes I forget. There, I did take my pin out. See, I'm a good girl. And also, you'll see that I'm pinning the wrong direction. As I told you when I did the 9-patch block, my mother taught me to sew, and she was left-handed, so my pins are all going to the left side when they should be going to the right side. So do as I say and not as I do. And there, I was just moving my pin a little bit so I could get past the end of it, but I didn't just sew over it. I pulled it out. And here I'm just going to go ahead and chain piece that bottom row. Again, I'm gonna get the two pieces together and nestle the seams. Put a pin in. In this case, we're gonna be starting right there where those seams are. So I'm gonna put the pin a little bit farther down again. And then one in the end to keep the edges together so that we don't end up with the fabric shifting as we sew. I'm trying to sew with the camera in front of my face. It's kind of funny. Later on in the video, you'll see that I'm trying to focus and hold the camera and sew all at the same time, which is a little awkward. Okay, so now both of the rows of the block are sewn together. And there I sewed over a pin, so I have to take that pin out. So now I press toward the dark side on these two seams, and what that will do is make it so that the seams are going opposite each other, which works out nicely. And quite often, if you are pressing towards the dark side, you'll find that your seams just automatically go in the opposite directions, which is really good. So it's really just a good idea to get into the habit of doing that, pressing toward the dark side. Okay, now we're back. Put the pin in the side where you can see the three seams coming together into a point. I'm showing you that again here. So I'm putting the pin right there where that point is. And it's hard to see in the photo, but you can see it here. Now I'm sticking it into the point on the bottom row. And what I want that to do is I want that pin to stand straight up so that I know that those two points are perfectly together. And now I'm nestling the seam with the pin sticking up, pin sticking straight up, and then I will take another pin and I will pin to one side of the seam and pin to the other side of the seam. And then I'll pull that pin out of the point. So it's all held together nicely. Now I'm going to put a pin in the end of where my seam is going to be, as I always do. And one about 3/4 to 1 inch down from the top at the beginning of the seam. I'm going to sew the quarter inch seam, and I'm taking the as soon as I get close to the center seam, I'll take the the camera down and point it closer to the seam so you can see what I'm doing right there where the points are going to meet, because I want you to be able to see what I'm doing. It's a little bit hard to see in the picture or in the video, but the pictures in the tutorial are really close up, so you should be able to see it really well. Okay, so I've stopped about half an inch away from the center seam. I'm taking the camera off, and I'm going to get it a little bit closer. Hopefully, I can get a good focus on it here. There, that's good. So now what I'm aiming for is that point right where the pin had been sticking in, right where those three seams come together. There's a little triangle right there, or two seams, I should say. There's a little triangle where the point is. And that's what I'm aiming for with my sewing machine and with the needle. And I want it to go right over that point. And I'm going to pull out the pin. Believe it or not, it was just before it got to the needle. And since we're right there, I'm going to go ahead and pull the other pin out probably too. Yeah. So that's about as close as you can get without running over the pin. And I'm going to go ahead. So now I'm holding the camera and trying to sew and hold the fabric all at the same time. And I'm not that coordinated, really. Anyway, so just finishing up that seam. And I'm going to run over that pin because that's how I do. Now, this is just showing you that that's where I sewed. I used a gray thread so you guys could see it well. And I sewed right where that point came together, and you can see that I have perfect points. Now where my fingernail is pointing, I'm going to take three of those threads out. Here I am using my seam ripper to take those stitches out right there where those seams are sewn together, and then I can gently pull those seams apart and press them in opposite directions. You end up with a little pinwheel right in the center, and it makes it so that your center seam isn't super bulky and it doesn't stick up. And here's your pretty block, all finished. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for coming along for the ride.